team started out this season with singular goals to make it to the NCAA tournament. Nick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the Winthrop Eagles and the Baylor Bears.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Bears are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Yeah, tonight like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, the point guard has to be the leader out there. He's got to be the coach on the floor. Second of all, make sure you take care of the rock. Turnovers kill momentum. And lastly, it's imperative that you win the battle on the boards.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Trying to go inside.
Number 15 receives the ball. Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
Wow, that's worth the price of admission.
On the dribble, gives it up. He makes a nice shot fake. For two, and off the mark. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Trying to feed inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Goes up for two. They still don't score. They look to get it to the inside. For the bucket, perfectly executed.
I have to see that one again.
The small forward receives the pass. They get that rejected.
Take a look right here. There it is. Says, get it out of here. Thou shalt not enter thy lane.
Number zero is feeling great out there right now.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
There's a whistle and a foul on the inside.
What a great job of putting the ball to the floor and attacking the basket, taking advantage of a slow post play.
Lobs it. Nope. He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's one you take for the team, Brad.
Number 15 is going to the line. Hits that one. Looking for a good shot. And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Tries one from three-point land. Nice shot. Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. They work it around the perimeter. Dumps it in. Trying to draw the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
And he'll kick it back outside.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Gave it up. Number zero grabs it. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Jumped in front to take it away. Number 11 handles the pass. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The shooting guard handles the feed. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Got the high pick. For two, goes. Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. And in and out. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. They work it around the perimeter. On the inside. Jumps into the defender.
The crowd will be on cloud nine if they can put some points up on the board.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. And a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Can't get the shot to go. Moving it around the perimeter. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with a deck. Where's he going?
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. They're 15 to 17 feet apart.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
He shoots from the elbow. Way off target. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Got a nice screen. Off the rim and no good.
Up and inside.
Entry pass in the paint.
Double team now, bad angle.
Here's the big man with a drop step.
Oh, he does a phenomenal job getting post position, good angle, and then the drop step.
On the outside, he's got some room. He launches a three, way off target. They're working around the perimeter. Inches away, off the rim and no good. Gets it to go. pass it stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Takes the pass in the paint. There's the pick. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
The Eagles are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. First shot is no good. Second one is good. Working it around the perimeter. Up fake. Number 31 picks up the foul. First personal foul.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Leans in. Number 24 makes the finger roll. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
They'll work it around the arc. From the top of the key, he makes the shot. Perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. He shoots from left of the circle.
He can't get the J to go despite running off the nice screen.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
At the half, the Bears are ahead by two. Well, let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Baylor displayed a spectacular shooting performance, Dick, in that first half.
Indeed, Brad. I predict the defense will come out and really be a lot sharper in the second half. They better be ready to play.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
And the slam. The center takes the feed. Number 15 fakes the shot. Oh, clinical drop step.
I tell you, clinic 101 on how to utilize the drop step from the low post.
The power forward gets the ball. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He makes the shot. work the perimeter. They've left him completely alone. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and now the spin move to the goal. Look at that spacing.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
The power forward gets the pass. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Can't get the shot to drop. Gave it up.
Watch out, 5 second call approaching.
He up fakes. Here's a double team.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
The skip pass is picked off.
There's the screen up on top.
Goes up for two. He puts it in with contact and all. There should be an easy bucket here. With a bucket, gets it to fall. Back to the live action we go. How's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
The power forward with the ball. They move it into the front court.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
He rejects it.
He's a high riser. Sensational, baby.
Had a momentary look from three-point land.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
In and out. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Here's a nice face-up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Drains it. Looks like the defender's a little bit tired out there.
This is no time to be tired. Get a sub if you need a break.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Pump fakes. Oh, clinical drop step.
I tell you, clinic 101 on how to utilize the drop step from the low post.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Dick, we get a look here at the front court players and how they're performing.
Who can dominate the paint is the question, Mr. Nessler. Sometimes the bigs get lost with all of the guard play, but to win consistently, you need to have a balanced attack inside and outside.
Nice high post screen.
Working around the perimeter. Great defense. Gave it up. Looking for a good shot. The power forward takes the pass. He comes up empty. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I think doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
For two, doesn't go. Takes the pass in the paint. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Number 24 is charged with the foul. Second team foul. They work it around the perimeter.
High post screen, gonna use it.
He drains the shot.
Inside.
Number 15 draws the personal. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
This is the second shot. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Looking for a good shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 31 is called for the foul. Second personal foul. Now check him out. Who would have thought? With the cheerleaders. Come on.
I love the zest of the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders. That's awesome, Brad.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle. Was locking on a box.
They get it out into transition. Shoots from the outside. That was nice. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
At this point in the game, block management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
Cross court. Number 15 is whistled for the foul. Third personal foul. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nessler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Look at that spacing.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind me because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
And Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
He steps up to the line. Up and in. Second one is no good.
They need to score here to turn this into a two-possession game.
Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
Aaron's right about that, Dick.
It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
Dick's six-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
The kick out. Defense giving no room.
Shoots.
He couldn't get it to fall. And here's a look at the foul situation.
Well, Brad, fouling and knowing when to foul is an important part of the game. If you have fouls to give, sometimes it's better to commit one rather than giving up an easy basket.
He makes the front end of the one and one. Gets his second. Shot clock is dead. He lets it fly. He shows the sweet touch. Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, know when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their teams.
Makes the shot. He hits the second. He attempts a three, rims out. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Bears came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.